Hi guys. Forgotten what the time is. I only just looked at the clock and I've forgotten what the time is. 20 past 12. Lunchtime. Daylight. Obvious really, isn't it? I don't know why I said that. With my eight-legged friend. He is now... Here he is, a little black dot right above my head. So he did a fair bit of moving last night. Yeah, just clear my throat. Right. Well, the plan for today... I'm actually debating whether to get a bath now, because I do feel like a nice hot soak in a bath, or reassemble that bike frame as far as I can, and the Claude, because I want to get them both done. That's the plan, anyway. But I really do feel like a nice long soak in a bath. Anyway, that red laptop I'm getting off my brother. Here's the keyboard. Relatively easy to get out. A little fiddly though. If you've never done one before. Because with this one... There's actually a series, they're actually on the laptop, but there's a series of little clips. And you have to push the clips in with a little flat-headed screwdriver or something, and then pop the corner up. And then you just work along, popping the rest of the clips off. It's only... Actually, I can see the marks on here. There is... Five, maybe six of those little tabs, but this keyboard doesn't really work. Now I found a newer version of this that will fit the laptop, but it's got a Bluetooth symbol there, not a Wi-Fi, so I don't know if that would actually still function as the Wi-Fi button. I don't know. None of that really matters, I suppose, because there's no Wi-Fi on the laptop. We had to steal the Wi-Fi card out of mine. Well, that doesn't matter. If I can't find a replacement, I'll just get a USB doofy and stick that on there. But if I just turn these lights on. One reason I've got no pants on at the moment, if you're wondering why I'm not pointing the camera downwards, is because I do want a bath, and I didn't know whether to get the bath before or after. But here's these little plastic tabs, see? And there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that would literally, you connect your cable into here, and the little board connector, and then that would just slot in there first, and then just push down. And then you'd go along, pop one clip at one end, pop the keyboard up, and then just gradually go along, pop the next one, pull it up, pop the next one, pull it up. It doesn't really matter if I damage the keyboard itself, because it doesn't work anyway. But, there's no damage to the connector, so... You've got to be extremely careful with these, because these plastic connectors do break. I've lost count on the number I've broken. But, yeah. Even the DVD drive on my brother's newer version of this is exactly the same. It's just like they took this one, changed the motherboard, stuck an i7 processor in it, and more memory and larger hard drive, and changed the design of this palm rest, I believe they call it, because it's got the keyboard integrated into the palm rest, so you'd have to change the whole piece of plastic to change the keyboard, which would be a bit more of an arse, but cosmetically, it's only got that crack. There's the lid that's damaged. I would need new lid plastics, really. Which I might be able to find on eBay, or, according to my brother, you can actually buy them from Acer themselves for £25. What have we got? We've got power on this side. External VGA, Ethernet, HDMI. USB, audio in and out, shake it all about. Card reader, two more USB ports. Now, my brother's newer version's got a USB 3 that you do have to download the drivers for, but Acer still has the driver support for these laptops. But for some reason, the card reader on my brother's wouldn't install the driver, I don't know why. I kept coming up with an error, I might have to fiddle around with that when I'm next over. But the card reader is in exactly the same spot, in fact most of it is all in exactly the same position. The USB ports and the ROM drive on this side is exactly the same. The only difference is VGA is here and Ethernet is over here. So the slots, ventilation slots for the heat sink is in a slightly different position. But apart from that, looks is exactly the same. They've just literally modernised it, made it a bit newer. I don't actually know how old this one is, but it has got a Windows 7 COA on the bottom. Right, I suppose, before I do anything, I'm going to go and use the toilet. I'm going to get the wheels put back in it. I cheated and I stuck some black paint on that hub just to tidy it up. And I might get a smaller brush and just get as close up to the edge of the hub as possible. It's a bit hard to do it with a chunky brush. That one just needs cleaning. The bearings I need to service on them, I think, before I put them back in. They were a bit sort of jerky, so I'll drop or open them up enough so I can get some grease in there. I don't need to take the wheels apart, I just need to get some grease in there, that's all. Right, well I'm going to do that and I'll be back later. Okay, it's going back together slowly. I've just got to go downstairs and get my tin of washers because I need a couple the bolts on the V-brakes. But V-brake's been cleaned up. Pinch bolt's been changed on this one. It's going to be changed on the back one as well. Bolts on, changed the bolts. Those brake pads are okay, but I changed all the bits in here. Spacers and that, because they're all rusty, so I changed all them. That's why I keep a big plastic tub full over there on the desk. Well, it's not kept on the desk, but that's where it is at the minute. Found one of these up. So I could at least get a front brake functioning on it. No, I can't, because I haven't got any errors. Oh dear. that's going to be a bit of an issue then, isn't it? Well, at least I've almost got it to the stage as far as I can go. I've just got to put the front derailleur on. I don't remember where I put it. I've got one in here. And that's for the Claude. You're probably thinking, why don't I put the better one on the Claude? Well, that's because it won't fit. Otherwise, I would, and I would have put the painted one, which I may actually repaint. Give it a spin over with my drill and steel steel brush attachment and redo it. I actually came in here because I thought the derailleur I wanted was in here still, but it isn't. Not that I can see anyway. Chain for the Claude is What have I done with it? I can't put the chain on until I put that on. Hasn't got to be in the exact spot, but I can't put it in the exact spot till I've got the crank and bottom bracket back together. I'm just going to get the clean out next. The other thing I've done, I have greased the headset bearings top and bottom. They were dry as a bone, and I could hear it when I steered it, so... and I've done the front wheel bearings because they were dry, but these ones are actually fine. So I just left it as it is, you know, don't fix what ain't broken sort of thing. So that got left. There's a little bit of touching up with black paint I need to do. I've been using this little brush for. Might just go over these forks again, to be honest, with the big brush. Yeah, I've done the hub properly as well, using the little brush. Front one will clean, so I'm not going to worry too much about that. I just want to get that brush to sit something like that, so it's not sitting in the paint. Right. Look at that. It's actually come up really well on that hub, hasn't it? Might use that stuff on my bike wheels on my Claude yet. And that definitely looks better than it did. It's not brilliant, but it'll do. But yeah, underneath all that oxidisation, white powder shit and paint, there was still decent metal, so I just went ahead and... I think it was the oxidisation of the metal then, because it's aluminium, that is. That's why this bike is actually pretty damn light. Because even this part of the forks is aluminium, at least. I don't actually know what that part's called. I'll just call it the shoulder, because that's what it reminds me of, you know. Head and your shoulders, that's what it reminds me of, so I'll just call that shoulder. Right. So, like I said, I've got to put a new bolt in there, which I've got in here. I've got two replacement bolts for the brake as well, but no washers. I've got to go shopping at Wilco's, it seems. Wrong case. I thought that was the right case, it's the wrong one, it's this one. Getting all these bolts in here. I'm sure I can find a clean one that'll fit. Yep, here we go. Where's the old one? Because I'm going to need the washer piece back. Oh. I took it apart over here. Here it is. I know it's rusty, but I don't have any of these bits spare unless there's any in my pot of washers. Just for now, I'll reuse that. At least it'll look better with a nice bolt in there. How come I got that to thread in there? There we go. I'm going to say I got it to thread in there. Without a washer on, I put a washer on and didn't want to go in. That seat is fine where it is, I can get on it. So, my shopping list is going to entail 4 cables, yeah. At least one brake noodle. I think you can only buy them as singles. And I do believe you get the rubber bit with it as well, so. And a pair of brake blocks. Then I'll have this one. Oh, yeah, and the bottom bracket bearing. So there is quite a list for this. I'm going to get 3 cables. Because I should be able to find a one long enough for the front in my spare box there. It'll save me £2 anyway. Ah, but then again, I'm going to need the outer, aren't I? So. And I'll need a rear brake cable for the Claude as well. And two brake cables for that. Right. Quite a shopping list to get two bikes done. But I'm actually looking forward to getting this one done for some reason. More than the Claude, I don't know why. I might just stab a bit of black paint on that actually. Just to... So much easier with this little brush. I'm gonna have to get some new little brushes though. Front one's not as bad. I might go over it later. I'll have till Thursday to dry, so if I'm going to paint it, I've got plenty of time. Right. I think that is it for now. I've just got to find that derailleur up, put that on. I've done a daft thing and dropped it in this box, have I? Nope. The original one is in here. But not the replacement. I don't have to replace it. I could just reuse that and cheat with the black paint, but... Eh. I've got that replacement somewhere. Might as well use it. When I can find it. Aha! I found it. So that's got to bolt on. I've got to find a bolt to go in there. Seem to have lost them. I don't think I've got bolts for those in these boxes. I'll be in my tub of bolts. That's nuts. My tub of bolts gone. Wheel nuts down there. Oh well, I've got a pot of bolts somewhere. Oh yeah, I know where it is, it's in the cupboard. That's alright then. I want a hexagon bolt. Or I might just look through what I've got in the box of derailleurs and because that's easy enough to get to actually. See if there's one in there on a derailleur I can pinch. Right. For one of those brake blocks on the rear calipers that I was going to chuck anyway, I had to use a bit of brute force to get it off. It all seized on. In fact, that's what's left of it. Yeah, bit of brute force, otherwise it wouldn't come off, but it's off now. Right, I'll talk to you later. I'm going to get on with the rest of this and some more to the Claude. Okay guys, I think I'm done bike-wise for today. I've just restarted Firefox, mainly because Facebook glitched. I don't think that was a fault of Firefox, but that was just the easiest option I could think of at the time. Should we try again? Okay, oh there we go, it just took a while to load. Every time I clicked on a message window, it just came up with drag and drop. File here for some reason. Right, anyway. Ugh. This is almost to the point where I can put it together as far as I can. I have actually found some rear brake blocks, or some, I'll try that again, some brake blocks for the rear brake, which I'll fit in a little bit. Front derailleur is on. I'm not sure if it's in the right place, but I have put it up with the original marks on the frame where the derailleur was originally, so. And the chain was a pain in the ass to get on because my splitter is on its last legs. And I decided, when I was looking in my box of derailleurs for a bolt to fit the front one, I found this nice Shimano Tawny one. Don't panic, it's not broken, it is. That's just where it springs to when you take the chain off of the front gears. So, yeah, I decided, why not? And I might as well have something decent on this. I'm not selling it, I am keeping it. I gave that fork shoulder a second coat of paint. So that looks a lot better than it did. Not as good when you get up close to it, but at least from a distance it looks good. And if these forks ever do fail for whatever reason, all I'll do to get them off, as this is seized in, I'll just hacksaw straight through here like I've done before. Drop the forks out, put the new ones in, put a new stem on it, and Bob's your uncle and Fanny's your aunt. But yeah, most of this is, to my knowledge, ready to have the bottom bracket bearings fitted and the cables. That's what it needs, it just needs the cables and the handlebar grips. So I'm going to stave off from the Claude Butler a little bit longer, only because I don't have any decent brake levers for it. So yeah, I can save a bit of cash and just wait until perhaps my next payday, maybe. So yeah, Thursday I'm going to be buying 4 cables. I don't really need a brand new one for the front, but I will need another length of outer, and it's going to be cheaper to buy 2 brake cables with the outer covering from Wilco than it is to go and buy it per meter from the cycle shop. So, and when you're on a budget like I am, you have to save your pennies. That is actually, I hate doing that because I'd rather support a local business, but I can't because I just can't afford it. Anyway, my Thursday might be a very busy day. Yeah, but that chain was an absolute pain in the arse. But my chain splitter is, I think I'm due for another new one. It's the only bike tool that I've had to replace so frequently. You can tell the thread's cross-threaded as well, look at that. It's not sitting in there straight. One of those guides where the chains sit, just inside here, you can see is also bent. The pin is bent. Yeah. These are only cheapy ones that don't look well. I say cheap, but this is about £5, that thing. From Wilco's. And they last me, I must be able to do about a dozen chains with them before they start getting worn out like that. And that is with me not forcing them on rusted and stiff chains, but the last chain I did put it through a bit of abuse. Oops. Perhaps I shouldn't have done. Oh well. Yeah, I've got those brake blocks on the computer desk there to go in. And I've sorted out a bunch of spaces and whatnot from my tub that's also on the desk. So I can get those on and roughly lined up. Yeah. So I was just thinking if there was anything else I needed to do. Find some reflectors. I don't have any decent ones with the plastic brackets. I've got ones that go around the seat post and handlebars, but I don't want them on this one. I want the ones that mount down here. Okay, that's not going to work. Shite, I'm going to have to put a rear reflector around the seat post. That's a bitch. Right, get away with the front one. I know I've definitely got front reflectors that I can stick on this bit. I forgot, it's still a bit sticky. I went over this bit with a bit of paint as well. Ooh, that is still a bit damp. That'll be dry by Thursday though. What are you up to? Right, I need to go downstairs and just chuck my rally back in the shed. Don't think I need to go anywhere. Do I need the grease? Considering bottom bracket bearings come with a tube of lithium grease. That's LM grease. Lithium multi-purpose grease from Castrol. Running out. But I know I can get a tube of grease from Wilco's. They do general purpose grease. Now you could use better greases if you wanted, but I think general purpose is good enough. It does the job. I know RJ the bike guy uses marine grease, which I'm not even sure I can get that in town. It'll probably be quite expensive, but oh well, I'll just... That grease works perfectly fine, so I've always used that. I've actually got a pot of different grease sitting over at the workshop at Mum's. I might have to collar that back. Anyway, that's going to be a sweet ass bike when it's done. Do I get a brand new set of lights for this one? Oh, decisions. I don't know. No, I think I can get away with what I've got. I do have some decent ones in here for now. I don't really need lights on it at this time of year, but I'd still like to have them just in case. Now, I've got this pair, and the rear one, I'll get it to bloody work, is actually rather bloody bright. But the front one's green, and it doesn't have any batteries in it, and it's a bit old and manky, so... No, I've got another one of these that work, and that is bright as... fudge as well. Look at this. This is the one I might go for. Actually, I cheated. I took the circuit board out of this one and put in here. Because aside from the clip on the back, they're both identical lamps. It's just this one. You can see the enhancements there, lens enhancements, there for two LEDs, but this one doesn't have them. That one does. That one's actually got a clip on it that I can use. I don't have a clip for that. So, thought I'd just swap the circuit board straight over and put in there. Straight fit. The only other LEDs I have are these ones. I could slap one of those on the front. I've got the one that I fixed. I don't think I've got a bracket for the clip. I might actually go down and bring that tub up. So I've got a tub full of brackets like this. And with these bits in as well, of various different sizes, hundreds. No idea what light that goes to. I've got another one of these. Smart. The black. That'll actually probably go with the green one. Yeah, it does, because they're both labelled smart, so that's a pair. Keep those together. One of these, I think it's this one, that's a green. dim as hell. Old fashioned one. No batteries. And one of those. Two of these, I've got to put batteries in them. Get to put the batteries in them, boys. Right. Okay. Well, if that LED did work, it probably doesn't now. When I go downstairs, I'm going to bring the other box of brackets up, because this box contains brackets like this, more or less. Other similar designs. So there's actually that bracket needs to come out of here. As does that one, as does the reflector bracket. Fuck me, that goes around a fat handlebar, doesn't it? Jesus! Right. Anything else? What the hell goes on that one? It's got one of these. I love these brackets because you can put them pretty much around any size pole or tubing, so they'll go on pretty much any bike. All you do is just take this bit off and put whatever one on you need. You see, there's just a screw through there if that one undoes. I'm not going to keep my hopes up, not looking at the condition of those screws. So I've got loads of these brackets for this type of LED. I think we're in. There's another one that might go around my seat post, actually, if I take the rubbers off. Another one with a thingy rusted into it. Although maybe I kept it just for that screw bit, because in my other box I've got loads of these without the worm screw in it. So that might be why I kept it. Right, yeah, I think I'm done. I'm going to go downstairs then, put my bike away. And, what was it? Oh yeah, bring my tub of other brackets up. So, talk to you later. Well, my bath got disturbed. What's the time? Nearly 9:10. Bloody electricity went out. Yeah, I have a pay-as-you-go meter, I suppose, would be the best way to describe it. For those that don't know what that is, it's, not where I've got. I'm dressed down from, waist downwards, undressed. Anyway. Basically, I don't pay a monthly bill or a quarterly bill or whatever. I just take a key, as we call it, so it's basically a plastic stick, out of the meter, go into any shop that displays a PayPoint symbol, hand it over, tell them how much I want, and they put it into their machine, they credit the key, I hand over me cash, they hand me the key back, and I come home and I put the key back in the meter, and that credit goes onto the meter. And that just went out. But you do get £5 worth of what they call emergency credit, which is designed pretty much to just, get you through until you can get to to a shop or whatever, to top your meter up here. Yeah. My computer doesn't like being shut down suddenly like that. and I had to boot up the second one, because obviously for some reason as soon as you plug in power, the red hard drive LED comes on, and so does both card reader LEDs, and I'm not sure why it shouldn't. Well, the machine's working fine, but the only way I can get them to go off is to turn the computer on and then turn it off again. Anyway, I just poured myself a nice fresh drink. Now Lidl's are doing these things again. They're called Stickies. S-T-I-K-E-E-Z. You get them free if you spend for every £10 you spend. So if I spent, I don't know, say £12.50, I'd get one. And if I spent, I don't know, £25, I'd get two. Or you can spend 29 pence to buy them, so I just bought these because the chances of me actually spending that are slim. So basically what they are, I've got some from last year dotted around the flat somewhere. Actually there's one in the hallway, it glows in the dark. Which I didn't realise until the other night. But I don't know what they're... Oh, they're going for sports people this year, look. A little footballer. And all you do is just... They just stick to most flat surfaces. Most flat, smooth surfaces I'll stick to. You can get other accessories like boards and books and things to collect with them. And I just picked up four packets at random. So have I actually managed to, by some miracle, pick up four different ones? Another one. I'm just going to sign the PC in. Apparently I can change that in my settings so I don't have to sign in every time. I might, when I remember, have a look. Because apparently my friend, who's now back on Windows 10, doesn't have to sign in. Yes, there's another different one. So I've got two green ones. The suction cups don't stay stuck for very long, though. What do you know? Dipped my hand into the box of these randomly, just picked out four random figures, and look at that. I've actually got four different little figures. Well, I've got another four at Mum's I forgot to bring home yesterday. Never mind. Right. What the hell... I've managed to get some lights sorted to put on my thingy bike, I think. I'm going to put on two of these at the front when it works. So I'll have quite an effect going with two of these. That's the idea anyway. I'm going to put that one on that I've already shown you for the rear. And I just hope that's going to be big enough to go around the seat post. If not, I'm stuffed. I've got some very early LED lights to go on my Rally Max Ogre. My green one. I've got this one. I have got some very early rear ones as well, but I certainly don't make them like this anymore. Not technically legal because it's green. Used to be. This also doubles up as an extra reflector as well. I had some like this before when they first came out in the 90s and I had like five green LEDs in, but the problem with green is it's not very bright. And plus, green over here is the flashing light for a doctor's car, so which is technically classed as an emergency vehicle. But yeah, I have got some early rear LED lights. I've got one downstairs on the back of a bike, which I'm going to take it off of. And I've got one up here, which I'm going to go get in just a second. I'm just going to open up everything. To shut that down, I've got to unbury the mouse. And acids, I will need those. Found it, I'm just making some room to use it. I'm going to shut that down. Now you watch. I'll shut that down. Got the green light there. I might get it. Where's my hand? Where is it? There it is. There's two of those that stay on, and the red hard drive light, which I've just noticed isn't flashing for some reason. But it stays on static. What the hell? Okay. Glitch there somewhere. Didn't used to do that until I swapped it all over. Right, now in my box of lamps here, like I said, I've got, there it is, it's right on top, so I just sat down for no bloody reason. I'm just going to put those on, because they're sort of an old style light. An old Duracell, and these old ones here, I wouldn't mind trying to find a front one to go with them. Or, I've got another pair of these I could put on. They were quite common in the 1990s, one of my school friends actually had a pair. And I actually had a pair of these, so I could put these on it as well. So I could have the old school LEDs and a set of old school lamps as well. Or could put these shitty things on. But they won't last 2 minutes. I don't know. Because these aren't bad lights really. Good old Everready, one of the last style of Everready's I remember them doing. I'm actually tempted to put those on my racer. Or an old Frenchie, I could put these on old Frenchie actually. One of them actually broke, the plastic was too brittle. Unfortunately, right. If you look on the back of this as well, it's got two orange buttons. See? One either side. How weird is that? It does work. It's not very bright, but it does work. That was the other problem with the early LED lights. They weren't actually that bright. Not compared to, to what we get now. Jesus, some of them are bright. I mean, look at the ones we got from, or I got from Lidl. There you go, you can't see my moobs now. No! Right. I have a flathead screwdriver somewhere, what did I do with it? Oh, shite. People messaging me on, have messaged me on Facebook. Bear with me 2 seconds. Nice small flat-headed screwdriver, and I think I've misplaced it. I'll pop the lens off, you see. Pop lens off and put 2 batteries in it. And hope the batteries I'm going to be using are good. Crap. I thought they were double A's and they're triples. That's alright. Some triple A's I made earlier. These JCB brand have actually proven to be okay. switching is so weird in this. That's what it looks like, it's lit up. But you can only use one switch or the other, and you can program it to use one switch or the other. So at the moment, it's programmed to use this one. I'll take that hand away just to prove it. But if I turn it off, press this one, then the right one, and then press that one again. So you can actually program it to you. You can't use both. You've got to sort of set it to use it. That's all it is. It's just an on-off rear light, and that is with brand new batteries in it. Super bright, isn't it? Although the M-circles do give it quite a nice effect. What's like with the lights turned down? Yeah, I'll put this on the bike. Somehow, I'm not sure which button I'll use, but I'm not even sure how the hell that would go on. Under the seat post, maybe? Right. Where is it? I've got both rear blocks in this, so. Oh, that reminds me, I have got someone at some point collecting a bike tomorrow, so I could go get the bottom bracket bearings and get all that assembled, and then Thursday I can whack everything else together. I'll say just the bottom bracket bearings because the bike is only selling for £10, so not a lot. Or I could buy something else, I don't know. Don't know what time they're coming, so I'm just going to check emails to see if they've replied. And she has. Yeah, that's fine. About 1 p.m. Whoops, I've hit the wrong button. On those lights in my eyes, now I can see spots. Right. Got another one of these where the batteries have gone dead in it, near enough. I think I threw it. No, I think it's this one. Yeah. Compared to the other one, anyway. Nope. Well, it's either that pair or I've got this one and a similar looking rear one on the bike downstairs, but I don't think I've got a clip for it. Only thing I can do is look in that tub later and see what I've got in there. Right, anyway, that's it for today, I think. So, thanks a lot for watching. I'm not even in shot, am I? Right. Yeah. Thank yees for watching, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow. Not sure what I'm doing tomorrow, but we'll find out in the morning. See ya.